Okay.
Thank you. All right, we meet again. I'll call to order our meeting for March 22, 2016. Jill, if you would, call a roll, please.
Mr. Matthews?
Here.
Mr. Paul?
Here.
Mr. Moore?
Here. The set of minutes we had prepared for us were the meeting minutes from March 8, 2016. Dan or Mike, did you have any corrections or changes?
I have none.
Me either. All right, those will stand approved as prepared for us. Public speaks, open the floor to anybody. If you have anything, just step up to the microphone. Come on up. Introduce yourself.
Yes, my name is Chris Zell. I'm with Western Reserve Land Conservancy. I don't see an agenda, but I think we're supposed to be on the agenda for a resolution.
There is a request in here for a...
Would you like me to make comments now, or I can wait?
Doesn't matter. You're up. Just go ahead.
Okay. So there's a resolution before you on behalf of Ms. Kutinski, who has a farm on German Church Road. Part of her farm sits in Lexington Township. The other part of the farm sits on the north side of the road in Deerfield Township in Portage County. She is making an application to the State Agricultural Farmland Preservation Program. And the Land Conservancy is a local sponsor for that program. A landowner cannot just directly make application, so they work with a local sponsor. In this case, it would be Western Reserve Land Conservancy. And so in order for Ms. Kutinski to make application, we seek both township approval to make an application as well as a county approval to make application. The county has been notified, but we haven't approached the county yet. Normally, we like to come to the township first and then approach the county.
This is a deal where the agricultural easement would be in the name of the Ohio Department of Agriculture and the county commissioners and the Board of Trustees?
The new easements do not require or name the trustees as a grantee or a party. The grantor would be Ms. Kutinski. The state grantee would be Ohio Department of Agriculture, and the local grantee would be Western Reserve Land Conservancy. I believe that has changed since the way they used to do that.
That's interesting. It might be preferable, actually.
So the Western Reserve Land Conservancy, we're a non-for-profit, considered a land trust. We do all sorts of easements. The ag easement program is just one aspect of our work. I will remind trustees that enrolling in this program still keeps the farm on the tax rolls. It will continue to be, Ms. Kutinski continues to own it. All we do is hold a restriction that limits development, essentially. She can continue to farm and use her land the way she is currently. It will be taxed at the current CAUV.
It can be used as agriculture.
Correct. Any type of agriculture. I think she pastures it right now, largely.
From now on, in other words, it stays in that.
Correct.
Well, if we are no longer named, if the trustees are no longer named as one of the grantees, then people can't come to us and complain about enforcement, right?
Correct. That is correct. Enforcement begins with the local sponsor, us, and then goes to the state. We currently hold 20 of these state easements. We've never had a problem with any of them.
Okay. Well, I mean, it's not a problem. It's a state program. If she wants to apply and seek the sponsorship, I don't have an issue with it.
No.
Thank you.
Well, we'll go ahead and give you this here tonight. Based upon your representations and the presentation on behalf of, is it Eileen Kutinski?
Correct.
She's going to be requesting participation in the Department of Agriculture's local agricultural easement purchase program. Move that we approve a resolution which simply offers our support for the LAEPP application submitted by Western Reserve Land Conservancy.
Second.
Yes.
Thank you.
Sure. Very good, thanks for coming up.
Thank you.
All right, anybody have anything else for us before we move on to the agenda items? No? All right, road department?
Mike, go ahead.
Discuss the 2016 speed zone study. We get a free speed zone study every year.
Mike, well, we talked a little bit, but what do you think of that? And if you are in favor of it, is there any place that you would like to conduct one?
Are you having any trouble?
I haven't had any.
I couldn't think of any, but that's just me.
I couldn't have any complaints, that was my first question too, if you have complaints.
Yeah, I would only do it if it was going to be meaningful. We were having particular issues on stretch of road or something, but I know that's counterintuitive to any branch of government turning down another free offer from another branch of government. Since we all know that none of them are free.
Is that something we can hang on to for a while?
Oh, I don't think you can bank it, but maybe.
I mean, I don't know if there's a time limit or.
We get a free one every year.
Every year, yes. Till the end of the year.
Well, I guess.
I'd be more interested in doing an intersection analysis.
I could check.
We've looked at this a couple of times over the past few years. And we know the one main intersection that has a very high rating, but it's already being handled. It's not being handled the way that we want it, but it's being handled. But there may be some other situations that we could look at. Maybe the fire chief knows more than anybody here. The intersection is more prone to accidents. You don't have to list them off the top of your head. But if, again, I think that'd be more important to look at than just speed studies.
Okay. And is this something that has to be one of our roads intersections?
Yeah, probably.
Just township roads?
I believe it is just township.
Because I do believe there was, I think it was on a part of McCallum, somebody had called and wondered about the speed on it, and I can't remember now. That was what it was. Whichever one it was a county road, and that's why I told him, I think you're going to have to take that up with the engineer. They usually ask us if we can, but yeah, that was one that.
McCallum's split by a number of lots too, 45 and 55.
Yeah, there's a sign up in the DAB, it says N45, I noticed.
Yeah.
So. All right, thanks, Mike.
Request to approve payment to Chase Inc. in the amount of $309.90 for miscellaneous shop supplies purchased at Harbor Freight.
So moved.
Second.
Yes.
Discuss tree on Bon Air. I forget
is
how it did.
Is that on the road right away, first of all?
It is. Really close. There's several maps that I've looked at, and it's like right on.
I don't know how I looked at it, but I didn't know if it was on the right way or not.
Yeah.
So what's wrong with it?
It's hanging out and done.
It looks like a good picture.
I didn't bring it with me.
Yeah. It was just on the text. It was just. It's leaning out. Into the road. Well, I mean, it's not into the road, but it.
Are we going to have another situation like we did on Florida or
Maryland?
Yeah, I don't know. I haven't confronted them or anything.
That tree wouldn't be as hard to deal with because it's not. It's real tall, but it's just, it doesn't.
Did you email that or?
I texted it to you.
Yeah. You did.
I did.
Oh, okay.
I did.
Take your word that it's not a problem. We already have a process in place for dealing with this, right? Somebody have it on their computer, you or Jamie?
I think I do, from Maryland. I have to look it up.
We have forms for everything.
Now that you say that, I think we did one for Maryland.
Yeah.
And I forgot about it. I can look it up tomorrow.
Well, if it's bad enough that it needs to be addressed, apparently you're bringing it to our attention because it needs to be addressed.
Mike says, well, he said it's getting worse. I mean, he's been watching it. Yeah, it's just down here on Mont Erica, right on 83.
The NoDOT was trimming trees out there, and I thought, you know, while they were there, and they said,
Homeowner?
No, I have not yet.
Wonder what they think about it.
Well, I think you should just follow the process we have in place, the form that we have. And I know it's a form that we drafted for your signature. That you've identified a tree that's presenting a hazard to the right of way and travel. And then either at the bottom of the page, I forget the exact format, either at the bottom or on a second page, it has the terms of agreement.
Okay.
Three boxes or something. One, it's either their removal or split agreement or we'll take care of it. But I think what we did before is kind of flip the problem first and then see what people would do.
It's right in their front yard, but the house is close to the road.
So why don't you go ahead and, that's something that falls under your authority as road superintendent, so you don't need a resolution. Just go ahead and address the paperwork, get it out. Whatever arrangement they want to make with you, we'll just ratify it for next meeting. The preference is, unless there's some unusual circumstance, like the last one, we recognized kind of a hardship deal, so we agreed to pay part of the cost. Mm-hmm. Preference, of course, if it's a homeowner that can afford it, they need to take care of their own tree. Mm-hmm. All right.
Request to approve payment to Fastenal in the amount of $124.09 for a measuring wheel.
So moved.
Second.
Approve advertisement for road materials for the summer road program use 2016.
So moved.
Second.
Yes.
Request approval for a purchase order to the Alliance Review in the amount of $303.05 for road material advertisement 3 times.
So moved.
Second.
Yes.
Discuss a hotspot options at the road department through Verizon Wireless.
I think I put them in. Can I put copies in the folder?
No,
here, Mike. I thought I did. Oh, Jim has one. Yeah, Mike has one. That's the one we were thinking.
Oh, yeah.
I'll share it with you here.
I saw it.
What are we trying to address with this?
For internet.
You just need it for your own ordering and such.
Yeah. Right now, there's no other internet out there without paying a nice chunk of money to run the wires down.
Yeah, Time Warner's not available. Yeah. The universe doesn't run out that far.
I've had several people on Greenmark call and request that over the years. In fact, I talked to a lady in Columbus at the meeting about it from Time Warner, and not much success. They just don't want it.
Yeah, they don't. So what's the cost here, generally?
That one that I like that plugged into the computer, it's free if we do the 2-year contract. And there's an activation, but I think they'll waive it because we're a government office, but I have to call. And then the last page is how many gigabytes? And what were you thinking? The two?
I was thinking the two.
The two, because then if we need more, we can go up. If we get too much, they usually don't let you go back down. So it'd be $20 a month for the internet out there.
And the unit's free.
Mm-hmm.
Is there a time that you're locked into that?
2 years.
You said that.
Unless we buy it outright, which it's $200, and then you're not in any contract.
And with the unit we're thinking of, it's just solely Mike's?
On the computer, yeah, it plugs right into the computer.
Access to anybody else?
Where the other ones have, you can hook up like 15 Wi-Fis to it or 40 Wi-Fis to it. Yeah.
Maybe people sit down our partner.
Yeah.
He does do a lot of research.
And allow him to get his emails.
He said he tries to communicate, make phone calls, nobody, everybody's email, you know how that is. Everybody's all email.
Hey, no problem. If you think you can use it, it's worthwhile. I think it's pretty affordable, $20.
Yeah, I think you probably need it fully.
All right. Somebody want to open a purchase order for it? Let me see if I can get this one right, huh? I'll maybe open a purchase order to Verizon for the 4G LTE global USB modem and the service at $20 per month for 2 gig for the road department.
Second.
Yes. You want to use that? Well, let's take care of your other situation. Want to go first on mine?
No, I just, we went to the county meeting with engineers, and I just wanted to make say that they are going to pave Beeson soon. It was about the first road on their list.
I believe so.
If you have anybody, I was just for information, anybody questions you about it, or ideas, that's all I have.
We need speed study there, and the laptop.
Hey, Mike, can I have my paper back? So I can order it? Yeah. Oh, one of them. I just need one. Thanks.
I understand that Hartman Engineering is going to work for the reservoir, right? Boat ramp and all that?
Yeah.
And they'll agree to a road permitting process in case they damage the road? Okay. Are the trucks primarily overweight or oversized?
Well, they're bringing in big excavators and stuff, so.
Could be both, right?
Yeah.
Overweight and oversized. What we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and have you meet with the representative, complete the paperwork. They'll need to sign this.
Okay.
We'll go ahead and authorize approval of it. I know that it's on our half of the road. Is how much there is it?
Yeah. Half a mile, maybe just a touch.
Okay. And there is a note here that Deerfield's already apparently under a $50,000 a mile long?
I had talked with them to see what they thought they were going to do, and that's what they were looking at.
Well, we would not want to undermine their approach. Right?
Okay.
That wasn't rationalization. That's a sincere expression of township camaraderie.
Playing well with others.
Yeah. I wouldn't want company to go back and say, well, Lexington only wanted 30. Rather than deal with a full-blown road use agreement, which may or may not be applicable anyway, we'll just go with this approach for an overweight and heavy vehicle. You'll need to just put the description of the road they're going to be using and just a rough idea of the equipment from the permit process. And then the other key thing is the timing. You'll have to get that from them.
Okay.
Essentially, the beginning date can be tonight, and the ending date, whenever their anticipated end date of construction would be, okay?
All right.
So I'll move that we approve in advance a special roadway permit for overweight and oversized vehicles for Hartman Engineering. They'll be using portions of German church, and if they cause damage, and recommend that the approval of a $50,000 per mile bond be attached to that permit.
Second.
Yes. There, Jamie, makes it easier for you.
Yes.
He has the room, though, if you want that back for your file.
Oh, okay. Yeah. You need that sticky note?
That's it.
Who's Chase?
I think.
Chase, that's our credit card.
I didn't understand that.
Yes.
I'm sorry.
So I should explain it. No, that's our credit card, because the bill's not going directly to Harbor Freight, so we have.
I was just confused. I wasn't familiar with that.
Chase, I think, probably first time it's been on your agenda.
It is.
We just hired.
Thanks.
Very good. Thanks, Mike.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mike. Thanks, Courtney.
Request to use the meeting room by John Summers on April 3rd.
It's available.
So move.
Yes. Another request to use the meeting room by Jeremiah Sellers on August 21st.
Yep.
So move. Second.
Yes. I have another request to use the meeting room by Corey Bailey on April 9th.
It's available.
So move.
Second.
Yes. Have a request to reimburse Tyler McElvain in the amount of $21.29 for fog juice for the fog machine.
So move.
Second.
Is he a groupie or something?
No. Request to reimburse Thomas Hobson in the amount of $23.45. That's for water and pop when they were out on the call on February 19th.
So move.
Second.
Yes.
What'd you think tonight?
I don't know. Lots of things to think about.
Yeah.
Where was this guy from?
KME. He brought that in because they have one available. So they can look at the truck, the cab, things like that. We're looking at four different ones right now. Just to get a ballpark so we can do what we want.
That's the only way to do it, I guess.
You got to.
Then that's it'll give you the room.
Different, but somewhere between
this guy and
4%.
Okay.
April 12th, yes.
I will not be here for that meeting. May I make it the following meeting?
Well, it puts things out in term.
Yeah.
Do we have a special?
Because I'm leaving on the 3rd, and I won't be back till the 18th.
Well, Ken, due process requires that we have it in all due expedience, right?
Yes.
We got the request today, so. What's the second meeting? The 19th?
That's just too late.
The 26th.
Oh, 26th, yeah.
That's way too late.
Do you have a special?
It's going to take at least 10 days.
So we really need to do it next week.
Can we do the advertising that week at time?
Yeah.
Do it on Tuesday again?
Tuesday, 9/6/30.
It's probably as good as any time.
Is that March 30th?
It'd be the 29th.
Oh, 29th.
If that's all right with everyone, I'll move that we schedule a special meeting for the consideration of the Fred Yoho nuisance matter for Tuesday, the 29th at 6:30 p.m.
Second.
Yes. I don't think we, I know we went as far as preparing this form, Jamie, but I'm not sure we have the next form, which would be the most.
Notice of the nuisance and that, but no. This is our first one.
So I'll tell you what, just address the letter anyway.
March. Next Tuesday.
Look at what they've cleaned up so far. And she said, well, will you call me back? And I called her back three times, not getting a good response. There's still a lot of pieces, parts, and. Yes, he did say that, and that he is not. He had said, you know, I know. Yes, he is. And the other is, we did have another complaint on Alliance Recycling. And he came in to show me pictures. And a big, huge, like 40-yarder dump over. And with all the wind, it was blowing everywhere. He said he's got people cleaning up everywhere. And he did get rid of one of the trucks that was parked in the area right across from it. And he said, you know, it doesn't look like we've cleaned up as much from in the front, but we're cleaning up a lot in the back. And I said, well, we just can't have the continual complaints. You've got to get a handle on it.
And he said, yep, I'm going to do that.
He said he's going to make every effort to not let this happen again.
When I come out and ask for your permit, I'm going to stand at the microphone and tell the board, and I'm going to keep it clean. Couldn't in the past because I had a problem, but now I'm going to keep it clean. And then the trustees are going to all look like you have egg on your face because you can't get these people to cooperate.
It's been pretty good. I've been going out every Monday and looking at it, and it's been pretty good. If you hadn't brought in the picture showing me the dump, up dumped dumpster, I might not have been quite as placid about it. But...
Let's face it, though, it ultimately does come back to us.
Yes, I know.
And that's because it ultimately is our responsibility. So, do we have a plan? Do we have any thoughts for a plan? Discuss this for the next month, every month, for the next 2.5 years?
No.
That's one plan. Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. Do we address something with a letter, a firm letter?
No.
No. I get tired of letters. I don't mind writing letters if they actually have impact on a reasonable, prudent business person. But when it is... So, let's think about options. Technically, each time they have a problem, it's a violation, right?
Right.
Do they need a violation or two to realize that there's some kind of teeth to it? They need to have a zoning violation? Are they in violation of their conditional use permit? Are they a conditional use?
Yes, they're conditional use, and it is conditional on them keeping the area clean.
Yeah, so I would suspect it's a violation of their conditional violation.
Two of them now.
Okay. So if they were served a notice of a violation, they could what? Appeal that to the Board of Zoning Appeals? They could have a hearing before the same board that he came out and told that he was going to maintain it, right?
Right.
Okay. There's one course, that's an idea.
Sounds like a good one.
Avoid all of that menagerie and have Ken send a letter or file a charge. Go that route.
Danny, are you willing to go out with me when you have a few minutes and like walk the areas that he said he has eliminated the... Because he had all those dumpsters and everything in front. They've eliminated all of those.
Well, there must be, I mean, I'm not trying to make a big production out of
it. I know you're not.
There just has to be a fundamental flaw in his business operation. He's got to be doing it wrong. I get it, your business is recycling, so you have a bunch of stuff around, but that doesn't mean it just blows away. Technically, that is his goods are blowing away.
Well, somebody brought the open container in. And when they were vacuuming or something is when it got dumped over. So it's not like it was on, you know, the property.
But don't they clean it up?
They have been cleaning it up. It was a lot of crap.
Well...
I'm not on his side. I'm just saying.
Yeah, realist. I mean, you go down the highway every day, those trucks lose stuff out of the day. But, yeah. But this is something...
Well, you're the one who's going to be hearing about this all the time, too.
Could we have Ken send them a letter stating that if we have any more complaints, then he's going to have to be issued a violation?
Only because it's been a long day. I've had enough grief.
Can I say something?
I guess I'm just getting nicer in my old age.
If this company has a conditional use permit,
yes,
and it's violating the conditional use permit, then we should issue a violation, send it to the Board of Zoning Appeals. They issued him the conditional use. If he's breaking it, they make that decision. By me sending them a letter telling him he is violating the conditional use permit, I don't have the authority from the board to tell
him. No, your letter would not state that.
It would be blown in the neighborhood. Now, it's inconceivable. It's hard for me to believe that dumpsters just fall over.
Yeah.
I've never heard of that. It's poor maintenance and supervision and business planning for that to take place. There's negligence all over it if your dumpster falls.
I mean, even if you write a letter, we're still going to end up with the Board of Zoning Appeals.
Right, that's where it should be.
So,
if there's a zoning violation, you file there, they'll have a hearing there with the board. Because when it comes up to renewal of that zoning for that conditional use permit, there are violations in the file. Then the burden's on the zoning board to determine whether or not they want to renew that or not. It shouldn't be with us. We didn't issue the conditional use. And I don't really don't want to substitute my judgment for that of the zoning board as to what they would do. Because they can completely ignore my letter, too. Yeah. But we're liable to have, at the time we knew, residents that live in the area here telling us about the debris in their yards and he's not maintaining that, they're before the wrong board. And then we'll ask whether or not there were any other zoning violations in the file about this place, and they have a right to attend that hearing and argue. But we'll find that we don't. All we have is lawyer's letters.
Well, the rightfully put it back on us. The residents relied upon us.
Yes, I know.
Say there's a violation, but I would just like Dan or one of the trustees, I don't care which one, to go with me so we can document with photos and written notes what we feel the violation is, and I'd like just a second opinion. Or we must let Dan do it because he's so good natured.
Can't we send him the ones that yell at you?
And that woman yells at you again. Paper in the back behind the fence than the other one did. So maybe it's a matter of them getting it bundled here and getting it out and not storing so much.
What I'm really trying to get across is what's the way to get their attention? That's all.
A violation.
So which route should we go? So now we're down to A. A would be Linda determining.
I sent him the violation notice.
Yeah.
And then the area people can come and support.
But I think that's only if there's an appeal.
If they appeal. If not, it's in the file.
Yeah, otherwise it's a violation and it's in the file.
When it comes up for renewal, they may have five of them.
And whatever date you choose for the violation, they'll open the file.
His original sentence was 30 days suspended. So we gave him 5 days, and if he comes back with another violation, then he'll have to take another 25 days and possibly more with additional fines. And did a great job. we've done everything we can do, now he's violating the court orders.
There won't be any more cars there now.
Not till June.
Well, I do think that it's in the township's best interest to notify the department in the state that issues the scrap licenses, that he no longer has a licensed scrapyard.
Well, are we at that point, or are we still like holding out that really, metaphors, but that really wrinkled olive leaf? You know, please come in, do what's right. Give us a minute while we talk about it, and draw pictures of what you can do and when you can do it.
After seeing him in court, I don't feel that there's, and Skip was there, he can maybe back me up on this, I don't feel that he has any intention of following any rules that we set.
No, that's why I say he'll be back in business in June.
But if he no longer has the scrap license, he cannot go to the auctions and buy the cars, bring them on the property, and repair them. If he decides at a later date to do what's right, then he can go back and apply for the scrap license again, which in which case we would give him a letter that he had an approved place to.
But is that a license that is site-specific, or is he...
Yes, no, it is site-specific.
It's site-specific.
Do we approve that license?
No.
No.
It's preempted by state.
So, right, so I don't, a letter from us would completely be ignored.
Well, that's an instance, though. She's suggesting that if, in fact, it is site-specific, and they realize that he no longer has the site authorized.
But they didn't ask us before if the site was authorized or junker.
They asked the zoning is all in.
But we never even certified it was zoned anyway.
Probably 10 years ago we did. Before the 2008. I would just like to notify them that he no longer has a permitted scrap yard in our township. What they choose to do after that, because I'm sure it's like many of the offices down there, renew it.
I'm going to once again show how I'm oddly becoming just a kinder and gentler person in my
with the aliens
fans. I know.
You want to go to Mahoney County.
You see, that hearing to revoke that license will be held in Columbus. Mm-hmm. So that means one or more of us gets to go down to Columbus over this junk car license. Because you know he will feel it.
See what happens here after he does it.
After he does it.
Yeah. I mean,
all right.
We don't have to decide on that tonight.
You may like it. 3 squares of a pot.
I suspect it will come back up.
He's got running water.
Question.
Right.
Yeah. At least we know for a period of 5 days it will not be operated illegally.
Right.
Exactly.
Right.
We got some relief.
We got some relief. That's the way I like it. Something good out of it. It's been an entertaining zoning department discussion. Anything else?
No, I'm not opening my mouth to that.
Well, we covered it. Final item under zoning, I'll move that we approve a purchase order to the OTA in the amount of $35 plus mileage for Linda to attend the OTA meeting in Columbus.
Second.
Yes. All right, Linda.
And just to put it in your calendar, Jim, mm-hmm. we will be hosting the zoning inspectors in August out at Walborn, and Regional Planning asked if you might be willing to speak again.
Do you know the date?
It will be the
Thursday,
third Friday of the month, I believe.
And it's August?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'll put it down. Any topic next choose?
Any topic you choose. They were very pleased with the last time, so.
How to enforce your zoning rights to attend. Thanks.
Never been to one like this. Happy at a hotel trip.
Nah, I'm just kidding. All right, well, very good, Linda. Anything else, Mike or Dan?
No. Thanks, Linda. We'll see you on the 29th.
Ken, anything?
No, not for it. For comment on what you carry on.
No. All right, believe it or not, we've reached the point where it's general township items to cover. First item is to deal with our 2016. They're very close. Who was it you used last year, Kimball?
Yes.
Yes.
And it was preferable service, was better operation and such.
Yep.
Yeah, they just need a good contact number for that Saturday, which I'll get from the lady, but.
And make sure they get it out a day early.
Yes, they'll have to get it out a day early because of the carnival, so.
That'll give Mike a chance to get in and sweep the parking lot.
Yeah.
Carney's coming in.
Well, again, the prices are very comparable.
Yeah, they're very, very close.
As long as the service is better, Mike, you want to go with Kimball?
Yeah, I think that we all agreed that would be for the little, they did a better job for us.
All right, for purposes of our 2016 spring cleanup this year, I'll move that we award that contract to Kimball.
Second.
Yes.
And Jamie, thanks for putting all that together.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, thanks, Jamie.
Next item, I'll move we open a purchase order to Care Works Comp for the amount of $1,386 for the 2017 Workers' Comp Group Rating Program.
Second.
Yes.
I'll move we open a purchase order to Aetna in the amount of $11,256.26 for 2 months of insurance premiums.
Second.
Yes.
Now, stop there 1 second. Are we going to make that adjustment on?
Yeah, that's why I only did it for 2 months. Okay. I didn't have the adjustment made yet, so I will have it, hopefully by the within April, before we have to do the next payment, I will have it adjusted.
And what you're going to do is allocate them exactly the same way. Whoever is on the insurance will be allocated to the
exactly
same account.
Exactly the same way as you, right. I just have to determine, well, I don't, actually don't think it addressed it, the fiscal officer's insurance could be covered. I know my hours, my salary can be almost small, I would imagine that. Well, would also be insurance, but I don't know if it's specifically addressed.
Did I give you the statute?
Yes,
okay.
I have it in the office.
I think it's very general to cover officers,
right,
and employees.
Employees. So I have to figure that too. I just have to determine what my percentages are.
Very good.
At least what the supportable percentages are.
Might be surprised. Maybe we can extend the general fund for a while.
Mm-hmm. I hope.
Next item, I'll move we open a purchase order to Delta Dental in the amount of $4,218.48 for 9 months of insurance premiums.
Second.
Yes.
Item 5 on our agenda we covered, which was the request for the land conservancy application. We need to schedule a meeting with Lexington Lionville Cemetery Board.
Great. The new board member contacted me to see when the meeting was. Oh, it's Joyce. But she contacted me to see because she had been told it was usually held in March. We had changed it last year at our meeting that it would be held in April. I told her we'd be scheduling it tonight. I do know if you may want to.
We can schedule it for March 29th
tonight,
at 7.
Already, I had indicated possibly before the township meeting, but you guys are going to be here.
Yeah, good.
That way we do it in March, like we said we were going to do.
And she is really active. She's already been up, I think, trying to pick things up.
That's a good thing.
She's already said that she's gonna, you know, she'll be keeping an eye on the mower and that kind of mowing and that kind of stuff. She's got a real interest in getting
it. Needed
a new chain, she said? Yeah, she was talking about replacing the chain there because it's rusted. And that's also nice to talk about. It's one thing too, when Jamie and I were looking back at the minutes, I realized that I was in error last year and didn't send them the invoice for their half of bins. Mowing, so I will have that ready for whether we actually recoup that from last year or not. I don't know, but we'll be going forward. But no, I'll send that.
Who technically meets for the joint board?
Who on the joint board is? It's one, Dan,
one trustee, and Mike.
The
and
new
Mike
guy.
Riley.
The new guy.
Yeah. It's one trustee, usually the third trustee,
right,
and the road superintendent, and then whoever their
And who are the librarians?
And I think I attended doing the...
And Jamie, because she did ask me if somebody kept minutes.
Yeah, yeah, that's me.
All kidding aside, since we are all going to be here, if she wanted to do it on the 29th, yeah, that'd be perfect.
That'd be fine.
Be very convenient for us.
Yeah, I don't think she'll have a problem, she was gonna hope whenever.
Figure, tell her seven.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, subject to her approval, I'll move that we approve a meeting for the Lexington Lyleville Cemetery Board for the 29th at 7 p.m.
Second.
Yes.
Now, would that would also be in the advertisement?
It should be.
Okay.
If there's any problem with it, you know, we can always readjust it, but...
I don't foresee any problem.
Great. FYI on here, we changed the dates of the spring cleanup to May 14th, and the Fireman's Carnival is May 20 and 21. Dan or Mike, anything general township related?
No, I have nothing.
We'll wrap up then with the final things, the cash revenue and expenditure financial report for year-to-date submitted by the fiscal officer. I'll move we approve that.
Second.
Yes.
Bills tonight are $24,421.07. I'll move we authorize payment of the bills.
Second.
Yes.
Miscellaneous communication items we always receive. I'll move that we authorize filing of the communications.
Second.
Yes.
Okay. Anything else, Dan? Jill, anybody? Anybody here have anything else for us?
We have a good turnout at the Fireman's Breakfast
Saturday.
Okay. Very good turnout.
This is our first meeting after the primary election. It's certainly appropriate to recognize the support of our fellow residents for the additional police levy. We do appreciate your consideration and positive support of that. I also want to extend my appreciation to Diane and Skip in particular as committee members.
We got it done.
Help with the levy effort.
We got it done.
Thank you.
I should add that we do appreciate the longstanding and ongoing relationship with the Sheriff's Office and sincerely appreciate all the support the Sheriff's Office rendered in our levy effort.
Thank you. We look forward to working with the township and getting our service back up to where you were and getting everybody well again.
Very good.
Thank you to the voters for that as well.
The sheriff, they came to the breakfast center.
Good.
Three deputies, or four.
We're very grateful.
Resource officer. Yeah, that was not like, told him out. Appreciate it.
Marlboro policeman.
What?
Nothing.
Our neighboring police chief.
That has to be an inside joke.
All of our neighboring police chiefs were here. Marlboro, Atwater, Washington. Fire chiefs, I'm sorry. Yeah,
Atwater just lost somebody from there. So that guy had attention.
Yeah, so. That was a shame.
All right, if there's nothing else.
Make a motion, we adjourn.
I'll second that and we're done. Thanks, everybody.